Hello everyone, welcome to my chemistry channel BL Das, short and sweet in chemistry. Also I want to welcome the students of class 11th and 12th science chemistry, and here the chapter is inorganic qualitative analysis, that is salt analysis for class 11th and 12th. Now here I will explain that unknown acid radical analysis, that is packet number 6. Already I have explained the unknown acid radicals, the 5 acid radical already explained, and so here it is part 8 and unknown acid radical 6, the packet number 6. That means here you will observe that what is the color, structure and solubility. Here color is white, structure is crystalline and solubility water. The word salt that is given to me in packet number 6. I observe the color, structure and solubility. There are two tests for the unknown acid radical or acid radical analysis, that is dry test, other one is wet test. Dry test, what test we will do? Here we will see that radicals may be. What is the radical? The radical may be. And here wet test, that is confirmed test. Here we will see what is the confirmed test and what is the confirmed test for that particular acid radicals, what we get here in a dry test. In dry test there are 4 levels. First level, dilute sulfuric acid test. In dilute sulfuric acid test, first when a salt is taken in a test tube and added dilute sulfuric acid, we will see here what happens. I observed there is no effervescence, so here no effervescence took place. That means here carbonate, sulfide, nitrite absent. That means if there is no effervescence, there is no reaction, that means there is no the carbonate, sulfide, nitrite absent. Then if it is absent, the group 1, that group first level absent, then you will go to concentrated sulfuric acid test. Yes, I have done. Now the salt is taken in a test tube and added concentrated sulfuric acid. Now here what happened? Here I have added dilute sulfuric acid, no reaction. And concentrated sulfuric acid when added, here also same point, no effervescence took place. That means chloride, bromide, iodide, acetate absent. If this second level or second group radicals absent, yes it is absent, they are not present here. That means I will do the third level. Yes, I have done. Then the salt is taken in a test tube and added concentrated sulfuric acid and copper tannins, then heated. When it is heated, and especially the third level, third group, that is only one radical, that is nitrate, NO3-1. So you should get, if that is nitrate, then you will get brown vapors. But in my experiment, in this unknown acid radical packet number 6, I observe no brown fumes form, no brown fumes evolve. That means nitrate absent. If nitrate absent, the third level finish, then we'll go to fourth one. What is, sorry, or only 3 levels are there, first, second, third. The fourth level, that is wet test. If dry test here I have done, that mean here nothing is present, then after that what acid radicals are present, there is no dry test for them. What are the radicals? One is sulfate, other one is phosphate. That means again, see, dry test, one is dilute sulfuric acid, second is concentrated sulfuric acid, and third one, concentrated sulfuric acid, copper tannins, and heat it. But if 3 levels are absent, then you will go to sulfate. If sulfate absent, then you will go to phosphate. Yes, I have done here first level absent, second level absent, and third level, that is nitrate absent. Then you will go to directly wet test, and first one is sulfate. Yes, I have taken salt solution, then barium chloride solution is added. Here what happened? White precipitate is formed, but it is soluble in dilute HCl. In sulfate actually what happened? white precipitate is formed, but is insoluble in dilute sulfuric acid, that is sulfate. But here what happened? It is soluble in dilute HCl, that is why sulfate absent but phosphate present. Confirm that is phosphate PO4-3, that means sulfate absent and phosphate present. Confirm phosphate. We will do next here other confirmed test for phosphate and then reactions of phosphate radicals. Next you will see here. Here I have done one weight test, that is barium chloride solution. Now the second one is, that is your ammonium molybdate. So what to do? Salt solution, you add that concentrated nitric acid, boil, then add solid ammonium molybdate. Boil and keep it for 5 minutes. Boil, after that keep it and wait for 5 minutes. That one I have done. Salt, to the salt solution added concentrated nitric acid, boil, then here added solid ammonium molybdate and boil and keep it for 5 minutes, and then you will find yellow crystalline precipitate is formed. Yes, I got yellow crystalline precipitate. That is why it is confirmed. What is that one? Phosphate confirmed. Again see, to the salt solution I have added that concentrated nitric acid, boil properly, and after that ammonium molybdate added, then boil it, keep it for 5 minutes, wait for 5 minutes, then see, I observe yellow crystalline precipitate. So it is phosphate. The other confirmed test, that is number 3, to the salt solution I have added magnesia mixture and keep it and wait for 5 minutes. Similarly here also I am waiting. I have waited. Then what happened? I got white crystalline precipitate. So that is why confirmed phosphate. Again see, here to the salt solution I have added magnesia mixture and keep it for 5 minutes. Then after that you will, I got that white crystalline precipitate. Then here it is proved that, confirmed that my acidical is phosphate. So lastly I have to write, so my acidical is, given acidical is in packet number 6, packet number 6. So you will write packet number 6, so it is phosphate. So what are the reaction? In reaction, first point, sodium phosphate take, so let's, it may be salt, may be sodium phosphate, and aqueous solution, barium chloride also aqueous solution, you will get here barium phosphate. Barium phosphate is a white precipitate, just like barium chloride, sorry, barium sulfate. After adding barium chloride, if sulfate is there, then you will get barium phosphate, and that is also white precipitate, here also white precipitate. Then what is difference? Difference that barium phosphate soluble in dilute HCl, whereas barium sulfate is not soluble. So if it is not soluble, then sulfate. If it is soluble, then sulfate absent, phosphate present. Then here ammonium molybdate, that is solid form, I have to add. Then what happened? In presence of concentrated concentrated nitric acid, not HCl, sorry. Here it is HNO3. So if HNO3 is added, then this is the reaction, ammonium phosphate, molybdic acid, then potassium nitrate and potassium molybdate, that is not important, that is act as a byproduct. Main product is ammonium phosphate and molybdic acid. In presence of water, they form a complex compound, that is ammonium phosphate, ammonium phosphate molybdate. Then here 12 molecules of MOO3 and 6 molecules of water of crystallization, and this is a complex compound, and that color is yellow precipitate, yellow crystalline type precipitate. So again see, sodium phosphate, that is our salt, that should be in aqueous solution, and it is the solid one, ammonium molybdate, concentrated nitric acid, boil it, then you will get ammonium phosphate and molybdic acid. In presence of water, it forms a complex compound that is yellow precipitate, so that it is confirmed phosphate. Then question is, what is magnesia mixture? Here I told salt solution you will take and that add magnesia mixture. That is, what is that one? Add solid ammonium chloride solid, not solution. To the magnesium chloride solution, you will take magnesium chloride solution and add solid ammonium chloride, boil it, cool it. First you boil it, cool it, then add ammonium hydroxide until ammonia smell is, you will observe ammonia smell. Until a ammonia smell is obtained. Again, see what is magnesium mixture. You will take solid ammonium chloride and it added to magnesium chloride solution and boil it, cool it. Then after that, add ammonium hydroxide till a ammonia smell is obtained. That is called magnesia mixture. So I hope phosphate is unknown radical. If phosphate is given, how to write and how to do all the practical, it is clear to you. And now first you will do dry test. In dry test, up to nitrate there is no effervescence. After that you will go to sulfate, that is for wet test. In wet test sulfate, but you will get white precipitate with barium chloride solution, but it is not, it is soluble in dilute HCl, that is why it is phosphate. And after that ammonium molybdate test, and after that magnesia mixture. Here you will get yellow precipitate and here you will get white crystalline precipitate. So lastly you will write my acid radical is phosphate, packet number 6 or 7. Now here packet number is 6. Now one important thing, according to availability of the reagent in our lab, we will do accordingly. Or please do according to the guideline of the chemistry teacher, and according to the availability of the reagent in chemistry lab, please do practical and try to understand all the reactions and how to do the practicals, experiment, observation, inference like that. Please do all the things according to the instruction and guideline of the chemistry teacher. I hope you will subscribe my channel BL Das Short and Sweet Chemistry, and also hope you will like and share my channel so that I can produce more videos regarding qualitative analysis for other acid radicals and basic radicals. Thank you all. Thanks.